Bobby Dodd Stadium isn't the biggest stadium around, but when the fans get it going here, it's as raucous as they come. Football is on the way. Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke tastes, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Georgia Tech tees up the ball as we get ready for the opening kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. And he's taken down at the 27-yard line. Clemson's offense really centered around this quarterback, and as he goes, the team seems to go, Kirk.
Brett, over the weeks, I've been watching him on film, and one thing I've seen is his ability to make good decisions. I mean, time after time, he just avoids the mistakes. And when you can do that as a quarterback and as a leader of an offense, you're going to move the football down the field.
Close to a 9-yard pickup there on the slant. Off to the right, and down he goes at about the 45.
Maybe after a nice run like that, you try to go up in the air for the play action pass.
Check four.
Nice run there. Pressure got to him, and he put it on the ground. Recovered by the offense. They nearly gave that ball away.
But luckily, that guy was paying attention to what was going on and was able to recover the football.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 45. Hits him hard at the 37. Thomas is back deep to return the punt. Thomas fields it at the 27. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. And he's tackled right around the 42-yard line. So the quarterback completes the slant pattern for about a 9-yard gain. Taken down at about the 47-yard line. Throws complete. He's got space to work. They'll bring him down at the 40-yard line. Way to the 30-yard line.
Even if you're pulling for the other team, you've got to just admire this guy's speed. He is special.
They spread the field in the gun with 5 wide receivers. Nice run up the middle. They'll spread the field with 5 wide. The middle for a nice game.
This is the kind of steady, strong drive that coaches love to see. Right now, they're firing on all cylinders.
From the 18-yard line, first down. He's on the run. And he's level at the 19. Run
Take four.
Hey, Al! Ruin!
Oklahoma!
Quick strike, and he drops it.
This one should be makeable. Georgia Tech is looking to go up by three.
Kicks away.
And it is good.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. He'll return it from the three. He's to the 20. Tackle made at the 30-yard line.
And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan.
He's tackled in the open field.
You know what? After a play like that, I wouldn't be the least bit surprised if they went to the air again.
Gets to about the 44-yard line. Fake and looking to run. Makes the catch and gets out of bounds.
He faked out everybody in the stadium. When you can sell the run that well, you're going to have the upper hand on the defense.
Brought down at the 22-yard line. Inside the 10. What a play to set him up with a first and goal.
What is going on with his defense? I mean, don't get me wrong. The offense is doing a nice job with first downs, and they're executing well. But the defense is just letting them maintain possession and move the ball right down the field. They've got to try to change things up with their scheme. Be more aggressive. Attack. Do some things to change it up. Take some risks.
It's second and goal. Ball on the four. Touchdown, Tigers.
A powerful push by the line and a really nice run. That'll get you into the end zone almost every time.
And he adds the extra point. A 7-play, 53-yard drive. And that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
He's to the 20. He's taken down at the 23-yard line.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play.
Let's go! 388!
Gets it. He's in space. Down the sideline! And they finally knock him out at the 23. He's got room, and he is drilled at the 10. And he carries the ball for a nice game. Just outside the goal line.
So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a three-point lead with this extra point. And he hits the PAT. It was a five-play, 77-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
It's fielded at the two, and he makes it out to about the 24-yard line.
Brad, this has been a great game to watch. A lot of competitive spirit out there. The offenses seem to be going up and down the field. Back and forth we go. I think the winner will be which defense can make that pivotal stop to secure a victory.
The offense will come out again hoping to have similar results as their last drive.
I love to watch a quarterback when he can really get into sync with his wide receivers. These guys have worked all week on their preparation to attack this defense, and right now it's really paying off.
The halfback with a carry. Tackle made at the 29-yard line. From their own 29-yard line, it's third down. Myers incomplete. He was looking for the tight end.
That's exactly how they drew it up in the sideline, and now they get the ball back.
Thomas, the return man. He's to the 40. He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line. The Yellow Jackets really taking care of business early in this football game.
Yeah, somebody forgot to tell them that they're the big underdog in this game and they're supposed to lose. I love their confidence that they're playing with right now.
I was really impressed with their last series. They came out with a focus on the passing game, and the offense got the job done. We'll see if they have the same strategy here.
He's gobbled up in the backfield. Georgia Tech is up a field goal.
Tech four.
Scrambling around. He's taken off. And they make the stop at about the 35. Quick throw. He's taken down around the 35-yard line.
Tight right. Four down. Hey, check 47.
Tackle. Lion. 10-9-E.
Motion.
He scrambles, runs with it, and he's got room. Decides to slide. Yardage on that run. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers. Looking to scramble down, he can't get away from the pressure. Somebody hit the upset alert button because this one looks like it just might be heading in that direction. 10-7, Georgia Tech. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two.
Blue 14.
He's going to try and scramble. Slides down. Georgia Tech has a three-point lead. The cavalry's coming. He's wrapped up for the sack.
After the sack, it's now fourth and long. The kick is up, and it sails right on him. No good. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Catches it, and he's looking for more. And he tackles him hard at the 39.
Double tight, guys, double tight. Four down, Mike six. Mike six.
Gives it off. He's tackled at the 39-yard line. He sails it long. Got it. Touchdown, Clemson.
White out here truly knows what he has to do to contribute to make his team successful.
Where was the coverage there? There wasn't anybody near him at all. Converts the extra point with a three-play 67-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points. Potter is lined up to kick this one off. From his own goal line. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Goes around the 20-yard line. A 5-yard gain.
You don't have to go deep every play to be successful. They got 5 yards on the play, and that's always a good game.
Now he tries to buy some time, and he's tackled at the 22. And he's taken down at the 35. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with 5 wideouts. Delayed handoff, and he's not going to get back to the line. That took a little too long to develop.
Yeah, the offense was trying to get the pass rush going upfield, but the defense did a nice job of sniffing out the draw play and hitting him in the backfield.
So it's 2nd and 13. Ball on the 32. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. So that'll make it 4th down.
On 3rd down, the defense was expecting the pass, and they defended the play very well in the secondary.
And watch out, they're going to bring the heat right here. The Tigers right now are getting the play out of their quarterback that they expected, maybe even better than they expected. And now, as we get near halftime, there's going to have to be some adjustments made on the other side of the ball.
Well, the defense has got to be happy we're getting close to halftime so they can go back to the drawing board and try to figure out a way to slow down this quarterback. I think that more often than not, you look back at the first half and you think about, okay, let's eliminate this, this, and this, and let's maybe try a completely different way of trying to attack him. In my opinion, they've got to take some chances and be more aggressive in trying to put pressure on him.
What they've done so far hasn't worked. He makes it out to maybe the 39-yard line. Clemson is up 4.
just throws this one away.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Nice run there. Delivers to the halfback on the screen. That's a great tackle at the 44. Maybe a yard that time on the screen.
Tonight's play by the defense to shut down all the lanes, so this halfback wasn't able to make anything happen on that play.
Thomas is back deep to return the punt. And down he goes at the 25-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Catches it, and he's punished. Tackled after a decent run up the gut. His way to the 49-yard line. He's got it with room to run. He's knocked out of bounds at the 47. Makes it to the 37. Makes it to the 27. So it's second down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the first down. Scrambling, and they got him. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Here's a screen pass. Gets it to the back. They'll bring him down at about the 21. They come out in an empty backfield. Just throws this one away. And this is the 10th play of the drive. In the shotgun and 5 wideouts. To the receiver, incomplete. He tried to hit his receiver in stride, but overthrew it a little too much.
That'll come in time. Just repetition, throwing that same pass over and over, and he'll be fine.
And here's another third down. Going for it all to the end zone.
That could have been a huge shift in momentum if they were able to hold on to that one. Wow, that was close.
Somebody jumped early down there.
Once you're set, you've got to stay that way. The slightest flinch is going to be enough to draw the flag.
It has the distance, and he splits the uprights. Looks like they're ready for the kick.
He's to the 20. Gets to about the 24-yard line.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Clemson is up one. Halfback's got it on a quick throw. Brought down at the 29. That screen pass nets maybe 5 yards.
They executed the screen play well here by getting the ball to the halfback. They pick up some yards.
And he's immediately tackled. Dumps it complete over the middle. Tackle at about the 43-yard line.
Tight right, tight right. Four down, four down. Hey, check back, back six, back six.
He's under pressure. Steps up. He's hit and taken down. Made at about the 33-yard line.
First down, 10 yards to go.
Ball on the 33.
Clemson's going to have to use their second time out of the half.
He steps out at the 31-yard line.
Throw.
He goes out of bounds.
Right around the 32-yard line.
And this is the eighth play of the drive. Clemson up a point. And he's got it. And he's tackled right away. Fourth down. So the kicker comes out. He'll try to put 3 points on the board. Kick is away. It's long enough. And he nails the long field goal. They can take a halftime lead by taking this one all the way back, folks. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 26.
Folks, that's the end of the first half, and this game's getting interesting. 17-13, Clemson.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Keith Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes.
We've been looking forward to this game all week, and it has lived up to billing. A close game. You feel like that it's going to be a great second half, and boy, we've got the perfect guys in the booth. What a reward today for Nessler and Herb Street to get this game.
Well, you know, it's not a secret, Reese. They get the best game every week that we think's on the schedule, right? So they got this great. It's great. It's close. It's going back and forth. I mean, what a treat to watch one of the best games of the year just unfolding in front of us. And more importantly, to hear the silky smooth sounds of Kirk Herbstreit and Brad Nessler. Does it get any better?
David and I will be keeping an eye on your game and everything else going on in the country here in our palatial and comfortable surroundings in the studio with the best seat in the house. Belongs to Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half.
Thomas takes it from the six. Oh, man, he took him down hard.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing.
He's on the run. Slides down to the ground. He makes his way to about the 45. He gets out to about the 44-yard line. He's at the 30. He's taken down at the 23-yard line.
Not sure what the flag is about here. Let's go down to the field and find out.
You got to be careful to avoid these. Penalties are a great way to stall out a drive.
So the penalty makes it first and 15. Gets rid of it.
Put him on the bus. Don't put that team on the bus.
Hey, check Mike 47.
Now, Oklahoma. Cut.
Gets to about the 47-yard line.
Chucks it downfield.
Throws complete. He's got space to work. And they make the stop right around the 10-yard line.
More plays like this, and the coaching staff is going to need to change up the blocking schemes. You can't allow the defense to play in your backfield.
Here's the eighth play of the series. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers.
He's tackled at the 2-yard line. Taken down in the backfield.
That's a great play by the defense. There's nothing like a defense being able to slip off of a block, get into the backfield of the offense, and then make a play in the backfield to be able to create some momentum possibly for this defense.
Fourth down. This isn't much more than an extra point.
It's up, and it's good.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
Georgia Tech gets set to kick this one away.
Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20. At the 30.
We're about set to start things up again. Clemson with a 1-point lead.
Out to the tight end, and he's got the first down.
Man left. Four down. Mike six.
And he's hit before he can go anywhere.
Throws it away.
From the 42-yard line, second down.
Mike six.
gets out to about the 42-yard line.
Nowhere to go on the delay.
Rifles this one out to the left. He almost had it, but it's incomplete. They call on the kicker for a long field goal. The kick is up. And he just didn't have the leg for this one. They head to the sideline with nothing to show for that drive. So we'll change possession with a score, 17-16, Clemson.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense.
He's at midfield, and he's tackled at the 48. Taken down at the 49-yard line. And the defense just swarmed over him on that one.
Yeah, they were able to penetrate the offensive line and get to the running back before that play even had a chance.
We've got a second and 11.
Come on.
Ball on the 49. Got a man complete, and he's hit hard. He scrambled. And down he goes, right around the 36-yard line. He's scrambling. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. Inside the 10. And he's finally out of bounds at the 5-yard line.
They're eating up a lot of field on this drive. I'm really impressed with their ball control.
And they got to him before he could get back to the line.
These guys have the capability to gain solid, consistent yardage. They have to regroup, come out a bit more motivated next time.
It's second and goal. Ball on the 8. He might have a chance. He dives and he'll be marked down. Rid of this one.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
Georgia Tech is trying to take the lead here. Kicks up, and they tack on 3 points. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20. He gets out to about the 22-yard line. The Tiger staff has got a winner on their hands. You've been around kids like this. They're just fun to be around.
They're fun to be around, and I think it's infectious. His attitude, I think, permeates throughout this entire offense and really throughout the entire team. It's no wonder this team is so competitive with him at the front leading the way.
Under heavy pressure. And he's hit immediately. Down behind the line.
Did you see how quickly he was able to get into the backfield and make that tackle? Not many guys that big can move that fast.
It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. Up the middle for a nice game. They hand it off. And he carries the ball for a nice gain.
Two tights.
Four down. Hey, check back. Back six. Watch the safety creep.
Little handoff. Makes it out to about the 40. Tackles him hard at the 24-yard line.
Double tight. Four down.
Mike six.
Makes it to the 22-yard line. Makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. It's the ninth play of the drive. So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. And that sets them up with a first and goal. Hands it to the back.
Touchdown, Clemson!
And the quarterback stays on the field as they try for the two-point conversion. Clemson is up by four. And he can't get in, trying for the two-point conversion. Kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Oliver from the five. They'll bring him down at the 35. Man, both offenses here in the third quarter have been on fire. Time for the defense to step to the forefront a little bit.
Makes you wonder which of these defenses has the ability to come up and make a stop. It could be one of those games where whichever defense comes up with that stop could be the team that wins the game.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Passes to the back, incomplete. From their own 35-yard line, it's second down. They'll bring him down at the 45. Down at the 47-yard line.
Hey, here we go. 47, Mike.
Hey, Jackson, Oklahoma.
Hey, handoff up the middle. He gets out to about the 48-yard line. Throwing, I don't think he got anything on that. That's three down and one to go. Clemson's up by four. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. A quarterback in the gun with five receivers. Throws it out there. It's picked off. He's at the 30. Oh, no, they really didn't need that.
And as a quarterback, you can't give up an interception late in the game. You got to be more careful with the football.
From the 20-yard line, first down. Clemson is up four. And he is drilled at the 11-yard line. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Around the 5-yard line. Tackle made right around the 2-yard line. He's taken down around the 1-yard line. So from a yard out, the offense is going to try to stay on the field here on fourth down and goal. Tailback here, and he can't convert. There's a missed opportunity by the offense. Now here comes the offense, and you've got to wonder if that last interception's weighing on the quarterback's mind at all.
I look for the offense to come out with the same game plan as before. You don't make changes after one play.
Nice run there. He's going to try and scramble. And he's level at the 12. He makes it to the 15-yard line. 3 yards there on the option keeper.
This linebacker's had a couple years of experience, and he's really solidified himself as a reliable tackler, as you can see from that last stop.
They'll drop him for a loss. Loss of two on the run by the halfback. Third and long here. Let's see what the offensive coordinator's come up with. And this quarterback needs a conversion here. Complete. He's got room. That's a great tackle at the 17. Kendrick will be the return man. He's at midfield. And he's taken down at the 46. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ballgame. Clemson holds a 4-point lead. Lawrence on play action. Gets it. He's in space. And they make the stop right around the 20. And he hits him hard at the 18. Positive yardage.
Man left, man left. Four down, Mike six. Mike six. Mike left.
He's gobbled up in the backfield.
You keep gaining negative yards, and you put yourself in a position of having to make bigger and bigger plays. Puts a lot of pressure on that quarterback.
It's fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit here. Kicks away, and it is good. They line up to kick this one away. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. They come out in a five-wide set. Now he's scrambling. Slides down. There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Gets it out quick, and it's going the other way. He's tackled around the 32-yard line. He steps up and makes a big turnover.
Yeah, he just made a huge play right there. He knew what was coming all along.
First and 10. Ball on the 32. Clemson is up by a touchdown. And he throws it away. And he makes it out to about the 31-yard line. Pressure. He goes downtown. Missed him.
Well, that's a great job here by the defense to knock that football away and set up a fourth down.
They're going to try a long field goal here. The kick is up. It's got the distance. And he splits the uprights. Looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Thomas from the two. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. The offense comes out to start this drive, and they're hoping for a better result as they threw a pick on their last possession.
This quarterback can make good passes. He just needs to focus on not forcing the ball to his receivers.
Lost the ball. And he's tackled at about the 27-yard line. Just under 2 minutes in the game. Fires this one. Caught out in the open. Inside the 30. To the 10. Touchdown, Georgia Tech. Here's the extra point to draw within 3 points. And he hits the PAT. A quick two-play, 71-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
You know, you always prepare your offense to think that we're going to have some success. I mean, these guys kind of be coming over the sidelines after touchdown, saying, yeah, I didn't expect it to be this easy.
Tackle at the 45-yard line.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game.
And they'll get him in the backfield.
Good discipline here by the defense, stringing the option out and plugging the running lanes. That moved him back.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 46. And he's taken down around the 43-yard line. And the halfback carries for a pickup of three. The Yellow Jackets use their second timeout. Gains his way to the 33-yard line.
So the execution of this offense has been on display here in this drive. They know what they needed to do, and that's pick up the first down, work the clock, and finish this game off. And with that first down, they may have done it.
Counterplay, taken down in the backfield. From the 34-yard line, second down. Gets out to about the 31. Clemson holds a field goal lead. And down he goes at the 23.
Game's over. The Tigers come out on top, 29-26. As we finish up the broadcast, what do you have to say about how this game turned out, Kirk?
This is just a tough, tough loss to take. Georgia Tech walks away from this game utterly disappointed because they nearly pulled off one of the biggest upsets in school history. But you know what? I think after the initial hurt wears off, these guys will be proud of the way they played today.
That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.